Hello dear students, I am Dr. Richa Sharma, Assistant Professor in the Department of Electronics and Communication Engineering, Punjabi University, Patiala. I am starting the series of lectures of subject Basic Electrical Engineering, BEE. The code of this subject is ECE101. This is for all the branches. In this lecture, I am giving you the introduction to the subject, syllabus and the relevant things to start with the subject. So, first of all, the content of the of this lecture. In this lecture, I will discuss with you syllabus of BEE, course learning outcome, textbook and reference books, format for mid-semester test, that is called MST, format for final exams, and what we know about electrical circuits. So we are discussing all these things in this lecture one by one. This is the syllabus for BEE. In this, the course objective of this subject is understanding of basic concept of electrical science is very important, as life today is unthinkable without the use of electrical energy. This forms the base for all the engineering disciplines: light, industry, agriculture, air conditioning, broadcasting and television systems, telephones, all are dependent on electrical energy. The aim of this course is to study electrical laws, DC networks, electrical circuits, transformers and electrical machines. So in this, we are having the two sections, section A and section B. In section A, we are having the content Kirchhoff's law and their applications in solving electrical network problems, star delta transformation, DC network, superposition theorem, Thevenin theorem, Norton's theorem, maximum power theorem and sinusoidal steady state response of circuits, concept of phasor diagram, form factor and peak factor of a waveform, series and parallel circuits, power and power factors, resonance in circuits, balanced three phase voltage, current and power relationship, three phase power measurements. All these are the parts of section A, and MST 1 is from section A. And in section B, which is a part of MST2, in this we are having single phase transformers, constructional features, working principle of a transformer, EMF equation, transformer on no load and its phasor diagram, transformer on load, voltage drop and phasor diagram, equivalent circuits, ideal transformer, calculation of efficiency, conditions for maximum efficiency. Then we are having the machines, electrical machines, construction, principle of working, function of the commutator for motoring and generation action, characteristics and applications of DC motor. All these are the contents of syllabus, which are divided into section A and section B. Course learning outcome. What we learn after studying this course. Course outcome: after the completion of the course, the student should be able to learn basic concept of electrical engineering, apply network laws and theorems to solve electric circuits, analyze transient and steady state response of DC motors, DC circuits, explain and analysis the behavior of transformers, understand the principle and characteristics of DC motors and DC generators. The textbooks for this subject are these, but the main book is B.L. Thareja, Part 1. This is the format for the mid-semester test. In the university pattern, we are having the two MSTs. And the pattern is same for MST 1 and MST 2. In this, we are having the two sections, section A and section B. Section A is compulsory, which consists of 5 questions of 1-1 mark each, and section B, which is having three questions. Out of these three questions, two questions have to be attempted by the student, and they are of 5 marks each. They can be divided into subparts 2.5 or like this. So this is a pattern. Then this is the final question paper, end semester exams pattern. This is of 3 hours and maximum marks is 50, passing marks are 20, and in this the section C is compulsory, and from section A attempt any 6 questions, selection 3 questions from each section A and B, means from section A and section B we have to select any 3 questions, and which is of 5 marks each. So in section we are having 5 questions, in section B we are having again 5 questions, and in section C, which is the compulsory, this is from this is having the 10 questions and 2 marks each. So this is the final question paper pattern. This is for all the subjects, not only for the basic electronics, but for all the subjects. So moving to the subject, here I am starting only with the brief introduction. What we know about electric circuits: an electric circuit is a closed path for transmitting an electric current through the medium of electrical and magnetic field. The flow of the electrons across the loop constitutes the electric current. Electrons enter the circuit through the source, which can be battery or a generator. The source provides energy to the electrons by setting up an electrical field, which provides the electromotive force. So any circuit which is electrical having follows this concept. So we are having different type of circuits: open circuit and closed circuit. Figure shows the examples of open circuit and closed circuit. In the figure 1, we are having the key, battery and the circuit. In this, the key is open. If I am keeping here, this is open. So this is a open circuit. The circuit is not complete. If this is a bulb, this will not glow until unless this is open. So this is a closed switch. The key or the switch is closed and the circuit is complete. The complete circuit is called closed circuit. Here I am taking another example. This is a cell and this is a bulb. And when we are connecting it, when it is connecting, it is called closed circuit and the bulb will glow. When it is not connecting completely with the bulb, then it is called open circuit and the bulb will not glow. So this is the example of open circuit and closed circuit. Then we are having different type of circuits also. This is another example to show. This is the symbol for battery, in which we are having the number of cells. This is called switch and this is the symbol for lamp. This is the example of open circuit. When this is connecting to this dot, this is called closed circuit. So another, in this circuit, this is a complete circuit. This is a symbol for ammeter. This is a symbol for voltmeter and this is for the resistance. These are the polarities in which the ammeter and the voltmeter are connecting. This is called cell. Here look at this. This is only one longer bar and the shorter bar. Longer bar is positive and shorter bar is negative. When only one, this is means only one cell is connecting. When we are like this, here we are having the number of bars, then it is called battery. We are having number of cells. And this is a symbol for switch. Switch can be shown like this, it can be shown like this. So this is the symbols which I want to tell you. Another, there are more symbols. This is a symbol for battery, switches, cell, ammeter, lamp, voltmeter. A for ammeter, V for voltmeter. If there is cross, it means we are having lamp or the load. Then M for motor, this is for resistor, and if we are having the arrow in between, then it is called variable resistor, in which we can vary the value of the resistance. All these things we will be discussed in detail in the upcoming lectures. So these are some more components used in the basic electrical engineering. Capacitor, we are having polarized and unpolarized capacitors. This is the unpolarized, in which any part can be used as positive negative. This is polarized, which is having positive and negative different. This is a symbol for diode, in which we are having positive and negative. This triangle shows P and this bar shows N. So this is a symbol for LED. This is for optocoupler. This is for photoresistor. Photoresistor means resistance which emits the light. When light falls on it, resistance will be shown. Potentiometer, relay, resistor. This is a simple resistor. Then stepper motor symbol, switch, and transistor. These are the actual components and these are the symbols which are used for circuit making. So capacitors, polarized, unpolarized, diode, LED, optocoupler, photoresistor, potentiometer, relay, and there are many more which we will discuss. These are the examples of resistances: resistance, simple resistance, variable resistance, potentiometer. So this is how we can denote them. How these are the symbols. This is light dependent resistance. Light falls means this shows, arrow shows light falls. This is switch. This is transistor. Transistor can be NPN or PNP. Relay, this is a symbol for relay. This is polarized capacitor. This is non-polarized capacitor. This is light emitting diode. Emitting means arrow is outwards. Then diode, simple diode. Then battery. Then we are having some more examples. This is the simple cell, only one cell. This is battery. This is alternate current, alternate or also called sinusoidal. This is direct current, straight line. This is earth. When we are having such type of symbol, it means that the circuit is earthed. This is a symbol for inductor. This is called coils. This is the capacitor and the symbol for resistance and symbol for transformer. Kept all these symbols in your mind when we are having the circuit designings. These are the some more components of electrical engineering. The components which are used in electric circuits. Symbol for capacitor is this, but these are the different type of capacitors available in the market. This is inductor symbol, but number of inductors available in the market. This is diode and different type of diodes. Transistor, different type of transistors. Transistor is having three terminals: base, collector and emitter. This is one of the basic component of the electrical circuits. This is the resistance. If we look at the resistance, it is having the different bands: band A, band B, band C and band D. And this is the color coding by which we can read the value of the resistance. Band 1 means the first digit, band 2 means the second digit, band 3 is a multiplier, and band D is the tolerance. Here in this table we are having the colors: black, brown, red, orange, yellow, green, blue, violet, gray, white, golden, silver and none. This is called Bibgeor also, or we can say that different colors. This is the first band. First and second band can be written in digit form. Then third band is written as a multiplier, and the third is the tolerance, and only gold, silver and none are having the tolerance values. Fine. So these are some examples of the resistances which shows the different colors. You can find out the value of these resistances: brown, black, golden. And here we are having yellow, purple, orange, golden. For example, I have written the values here also: yellow 4, purple 7, orange is a multiplier, means third multiplier, 10 raised to power 3, and golden is the tolerance 5%. Fine. Similarly, we can find out the value of this also. This is an assignment for you people to find out the values of the resistances. I have given you 5 resistances shown here. According to the table, find out the values of these resistances. Fine. We are having here brown, black, red, and golden. Here we are having brown, black, red, silver. Here we are having yellow, blue, red, and golden. Here we are having blue, red, brown, golden. Similarly, here brown, black, and blue. Here we are having the 4 bands. The last one is our tolerance, and before that is our multiplier, and here we are having the 3 digits. Fine. First band, second band, and third band, and fourth band. Fourth band is multiplier, and last one is our tolerance. Fine. So find out the values of these resistances. This is all about your today's lecture. Thank you so much. Hope you like this lecture. I will upload this lecture on the YouTube channel. Please like, subscribe my YouTube channel for next lectures also. Thank you so much.